Josh Lambert here with Centerville Tech. Today I'm going to show you how to install an extension into MediaWiki. To get started, you'll need to have a functional install of MediaWiki. I've installed a copy of MediaWiki onto my Bluehost server. You can install this on a web host of your choice. Once that's done, you're ready to now install extensions into MediaWiki. Secondly, you'll need to have an FTP client, as well as the FTP login information for your server. I recommend using the free FileZilla client. You can get this by going to google.com, searching for FileZilla. It'll be the first link that comes up. Go ahead and download and install a copy of that. Get your server's FTP login information and connect to it. We're going to verify we can connect to our server over FTP. By opening the site manager, I'm going to connect here to my test wiki that I've already set up. You can see I've got my server's host name as well as the FTP username and password. We're going to press the connect button. And as you can see here, I'm now looking at the files over here on the right side on my server. So I am successfully able to connect over FTP. Until you're able to connect over FTP, pause this video, get that working, then come back and we will continue the tutorial here showing you how to install an extension. Next, we're going to go back to the MediaWiki extension page. The extension I'm going to be installing today is called Cite, C-I-T-E. This is used for doing footnotes on your wiki to cite your sources for things you're saying in your article. And that's what this extension is used for. On the extension page, we're going to scroll down and locate the Download Snapshot button. You'll find it here, and we're going to click that link. Next, it's going to ask us what version of the MediaWiki software we're using. You can determine this by going back to your wiki, clicking the Special Pages link on the toolbar, scroll down, and underneath the Data and Tools section, look for the link that says Version. Click that link. And here you'll see we have under the Installed Software table, we have MediaWiki version 1.23.6. So we're on version 1.23. Back over on the MediaWiki extension page, we're going to drop the menu down, and we're going to choose version 1.23. Next, we're going to press the blue continue button. Now the download's going to start automatically with a tarball of this extension. If you're on Mac, you can extract this tarball simply by clicking the file after it's downloaded. So you can see here that underneath my downloads pane, I have the tarball. I click it, it's going to extract it automatically, and you see here I now have the site folder. If you're on Windows, you'll need to get the free 7-zip utility. You can find this by going to Google, Googling 7-zip, download that tool, and use that to extract your tarball files. So now we have a copy of the extension. We're going to upload this folder to our server. We're going to go back to FileZilla, and then we're going to, inside of our wiki folder here, scroll down and find the extensions folder. There it is. We're going to go into it. And you can see here I've already got some other extensions that are located in here, such as Wiki Editor and Rename User. You can see there's a group of them in here. Over here under the download side, I'm going to refresh so I can see the files that I've downloaded in here. You can see now that the site folder has appeared. You're going to highlight this folder, then right-click it and choose the upload option. At this point, FileZilla is now uploading a copy of the plugin to the server. Now, on a side note, I really, really like FileZilla for doing FTPing because FileZilla allows you to upload multiple files at the same time. So when you've got an extension that's got 300 plus files in it, it'll upload a lot quicker than if it were doing this one file at a time. FileZilla is incredible. I highly recommend it. And it looks like at this point the extension has now been uploaded, but we're not quite done yet. Next, we need to go to the configuration file for the wiki software and tell it that the site extension is now available and can be loaded. Back over here under the server pane, we're going to go up a directory, back into our wiki's root folder. You can see here we've got all the files that are in here. And we're going to look for the folder, the file rather, that says local settings. There it is, localsettings.php, and download a copy of that. Next, we're going to right-click this file, and we're going to choose the Edit option. When it opens, we're going to scroll all the way down to the bottom of the file here. You can see that it's kind of big. We're going to go down to the bottom. You're going to see two lines. One of them will say End of Automatically Generated Settings. The other is going to say Add More Configuration Options below. Next, you need to add a line that's typed exactly as the one below. You're going to type require underscore once. Then we're going to give it the path of where this extension is located. So we'll load up the global variable IP, and then we're going to do /extensions. /site.php, and then we're going to add our line terminator. Now, it's very important that you get the spelling and the capitalization right. If this isn't typed correctly, you may see a white page on your wiki when you refresh the screen if this is not typed correctly. It's also worth noting that these directions I'm giving you here are for MediaWiki version 1.24 and earlier. If you're using 1.25, the process is a little different, and it's really the changes are what you're entering into this local settings file here. If you're using 1.25, like my video, leave me a comment, and let me know, and I will post a video giving directions for the newer wiki version as well. Let's continue. We have our path typed up here now, IP:/extensions:/site:/site.php. We're going to save the changes to our file. Back over here now, FileZilla is going to detect that we made an edit to the file. We're going to go ahead and press the Yes button, which will upload the changes we made back to the server. Changes are now uploaded. We can verify that the plugin is now functioning as it is expected to by returning to the version page of our wiki here and refreshing the page. Okay. Now, if all goes well, you won't get a white page, you won't get any errors, and if you scroll down here under Installed Extensions, you'll now see that Site has been installed. Folks, that's pretty much all there is to it. If you have questions, feel free to leave me a question down in the comments, and I'll do my best to get back to you. You can also send me an email, which is going to be at hi@centervilletech.com, and I'll try to respond to your question perhaps with another video here on YouTube. Thank y'all, and enjoy your wikis, enjoy your new site extension, or whatever the extension is you're using. Take care, and God bless.